annoys when people say they have it when they don't. It's not like the flu, you can't just catch it. If you've got it, it's gonna stay with you. It goes round and round in your brain and it won't stop. It's like a constant nagging in your ear. It was with me ever since I was born. I remember my parents telling me that I was a bit unusual because as a baby, when I was like in the pram, if people looked at me, I would just start crying. When people touched me or anything, I would just freak out. It wasn't an average reaction. My parents didn't really think much of it at first. They just thought, you know, it was quite normal, you know, when children are young, they're gonna cry. So at primary school, I'd be taken into the classroom before anybody else because then I wouldn't be causing a scene and it would like give me time to settle in before all the other pupils came in. I remember in year four being told off and then I pretended I was ill so I could go home so I wouldn't have to go back into the lesson. And then ever since then, really, that's kind of been my thing, to just pretend I was ill so I wouldn't have to go to the place I didn't want to or do something I didn't want to. It was my second year in secondary school that it all started to kick off, but we didn't know if it was just me turning into a teenager or if it was just school. So we kind of settled for it was just me being a teenager. And then when I was in lessons, I could never concentrate because I could just sense different people around me and I'd almost have like a radar. So different people would be higher up on my radar because they'd be almost like a danger to me. And because of that, I could just never concentrate. I was always thinking about if something ever happened, what I could do, how to get out quickly and safely. And then in year 11, I seemed to be okay again after the holidays. I was going into school all the way up until Halloween. That was my last day at school. Because then, I don't know, something just clicked in my brain and I just didn't go in. I remember pretending I was ill for a whole week and then school ended up ringing me up being like, why aren't you in school? So then I went in that afternoon just because I realised I'd like been caught out, you know, people are beginning to realise that I'm not there. Then after the Christmas break, that's when it all like got really bad because I started not going into lessons and I went into the pupil support unit instead because I wasn't coping. I just physically could not cope with being in lessons. So months later, I went to go and see CAMHS, which is the Child and Adolescent Mental Health Service. When they first did the first like evaluation about me, they kind of put me down as a complex case. After a little while of being seen by CAMHS, they put me on a drug called sertraline, which is supposed to help calm your brain down. When I was on the sertraline, it did help me feel calmer, but there are a lot of side effects to it as well, and the two that affected me the most were insomnia and fatigue. So the mixture of that wasn't a good outcome because I wouldn't be sleeping at night time, but then I'd be tired anyway during the day. So even though it did help me feel less nervous on days when I wasn't going to college or stuff like that, I basically just lay in bed all day. I didn't do anything. Not being able to sleep from the medication really affected me a lot. So it affected me so much that I just came off it because CAMHS weren't helping me, they weren't seeing me. And I just thought I was so out of control of everything that was happening. I didn't like it. I got a load of side effects really quickly. So I got these things called brain zaps where every time you look, it feels like you're getting an electrical shock. And then also it felt like all my senses were mixed up in my brain. So it kind of felt like I couldn't hear and smell things properly. And then also I became really disorientated, and that was a follow-on from the brain zaps. So if I got more nervous because I wasn't on the medication, I would look around more to make sure I was in a safe environment. And because of that, the brain zaps would happen more, and then I'd feel disorientated, and it kind of felt like the whole world was like spinning. I used to feel so alone because there was no support from school and CAMHS weren't helping me, and I just felt like I was in this by myself. It is still a taboo topic, which I just don't understand, because so many young people have it and it just really doesn't make any sense to me. I can imagine I would have been a lot more of a fun person if I didn't have it. You know, I would have gone out with other teenagers and done stuff they would have done, but at the minute that's just stuff I can never imagine doing. My name is Sarah and I have anxiety.